Previously on Yu-Gi-Oh!
Mr. Worf, dispatch a subspace message to Admiral Hansen. We have engaged the Borg.
All you know is how to play it safe. If you can't make the big decisions, Commander, then I suggest you make room for someone who can.
Whee! Ow, my hair! Hey, what the...
If we can generate a concentrated burst of power at that same frequency distribution,
how do we do that?
The main deflector dish!
I am LittleKuriboh of Borg. From this time forward, you will service us.
Mr. Worf. Fire!
And now the conclusion.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip.
Master Merrick, we should be arriving in Domino City in approximately 4 episodes.
Excellent! That gives us time for at least one children's card game. By the way, from now on I want you to call me the Skipper. And you can be Gilligan.
As you wish, Master Merrick.
Excellent! Now to awaken the newest addition to the family, Steve.
Dude.
Rise and shine, my little mind puppet.
Dude.
I only just realized, Pharaoh, but you haven't got a reflection. Is there something you're not telling me?
Yugi, I'm an ancient spirit living inside your body. Of course I don't have-
Don't lie to me. You're a vampire, aren't you?
It's the middle of the day.
Well, that proves nothing.
I never should have let you read Twilight.
We meet once again for the first time, Pharaoh.
Merrick, you coward. Why do you keep using innocent bystanders as pawns in your deadly game?
Innocent? Are you kidding me? Have you seen this guy? He's got piercings all over his body. You've got to be pretty f***ed up to agree to something like that.
He's still a human being.
He's also a mime.
Oh, in that case, yeah, I'll kick his ass.
Wonder Twin Powers activate. Form of... an Egyptian homosexual.
Now, Merrick, I shall take control of Yugi's body to defeat you in a children's card game.
Oh, right, because when I take control of somebody to make them play a card game, that's pure evil. But when you do it, it's like your mother friggin' Teresa.
Jeez, this guy is nothing but a whiny teenager with magical powers. He's Harry Potter, that's who he is.
Well, why don't you just suck blood from his neck, Nosferatu?
Interesting. My gaydar has led me to this museum. I hope it's not another false alarm. The last time this happened, it was at a Kevin Spacey autograph signing, and everybody knows he's as straight as a die. I like that word. Die.
Oh, mighty giant rock. Sometimes I think you are the only one who truly understands me. What's this? I sense an evil presence approaching. Well, I wouldn't want to get involved with the plot, so I think I'll just go hide.
Such a powerful source of gay energy. And it's mine for the taking. Oh, blast. I knew I should have recharged the batteries before I left the house this morning. This is no ordinary giant rock. It's also a giant plot device. And very soon I shall use it to destroy the Pharaoh and everything he holds dear, give or take a few hundred episodes.
You call yourself a Pharaoh, but you don't even know how to use your power. That's why destiny has chosen me to take it from you.
What power are you talking about?
Foolish fool! I'm talking about the power to look good in leather.
That power belongs to me and me alone. And maybe NSYNC, but mostly to me. And I won't let you take it without a fight.
We'll see how strong you are when you're trapped inside my nightmare steel cage.
Despite all my rage, I am still just a rat in a cage.
And now I summon the Egyptian god card, Slifer, the executive producer.
I hunger.
Holy Mumra! Look at the size of that thing! It makes Kaiba's ego look positively minuscule.
Cower in fear, Pharaoh, because Slifer is going to executive produce the crap out of you.
Joey, what's the matter with you? You haven't played a card game in one whole episode. You gotta get back in the game, man.
No, from now on, I only duel minor characters from season one. That's how I roll.
But Joey...
That is how I roll, Tristan.
What the hell's going on here? I specifically requested that Joey Wheeler be banned from my tournament. Somebody must have f***ed up big time.
Hey, Kaiba, you're a minor character from season one. How about a duel?
There wasn't a single word you just said that didn't make me want to kill you.
Mr. Kaiba, our scanners have detected that an Egyptian god card has been summoned somewhere in the city. If you climb on board, we'll take you to the signal's location.
And now I have a boner.
You're finished, Pharaoh. For every card I have in my hand, Slifer's attack power increases. And with my revival gem in play, you can't hope to touch my life points. Now I play the card of safe return, which allows me to draw three more cards every time my revival gem is sent to the graveyard. It's your move, Yugi.
You know something, Marek? Dueling you is like playing on the Nintendo Wii. It got boring after about 5 minutes.
Silence! Soon you will be crushed, and people all over the place will marvel at my leather-clad tushy.
Run, coward!
He's right. How can I hope to defeat an Egyptian god card?
Quit your sniveling, Yugi.
Huh?
Just because this guy has an Egyptian god card, it doesn't mean he's going to win. You and I both know that there's more to card games than having the most powerful monsters. A true duelist doesn't rely on his cards alone. If you want to win this match, you're gonna have to take a page out of my book and screw the rules.
He's right, and I know just how to do it. I'll use brain control to take control of his revival jam. Now, every time Slifer destroys my Revival Gem monster, he'll be forced to draw three new cards. And when Revival Gem returns to the field, Slifer's special ability means it has to attack any new monster that appears, starting the whole process over again. This will continue until he no longer has any cards left in his deck, rendering me the winner by default.
Yugi, you took advantage of a glaring flaw in the Duel Monsters rulebook. Truly, you are an honorable duelist.
Fools! It doesn't matter if you take Slifer the executive producer, for I have an even stronger god card up my sleeve. Soon I shall arrive in Domino City, where my Steve squad is already preparing to capture your beloved friends Taya, Tristan, and Joey. And don't bother trying to find them, for they are masters of disguise.
Damn it! I have to save my friends.
See, Mokuba? This is why I don't let you have friends.
Everybody have seen my balls, they're big and salty and brown. If you ever need a quick pick-me-up, just stick my balls in your mouth. Ooh, suck on my chocolate salted balls. Stick them in your mouth and suck them. Suck on my chocolate salted balls. They're packed full of vitamins and good for you. So suck on my balls.
Dude.